Head tracking is a very useful tool for many in the flight simulation market. It allows for natural head movements without the cost and heft of a VR headset. Many of the pre-made options available on the market provide their own strengths and weaknesses, from the Dell Inclip to TrackHead and to Natural Point's TrackIR. Today I'm going to be reviewing a wireless head tracker from RJ SimTech, known as the IR TrackStar. I've been using it for a month now and I feel I can give a good opinion on it and what I thought of it. Please note that I am using a PS3i camera with an IR filter that has been removed for head tracking and not a TrackIR head tracking camera. I also must state that I will send this unit in as a review unit, however, this will not affect my opinion on the product as I give you my truthful and honest review on this product. Anyways, with that out of the way, let's get into the video. The tracking distance on the IR TrackStar is superb and works well. I can easily use it without losing tracking from 1.25 meters away from my desk, being able to turn my head quite far before actually losing my head tracking capability. Of course, with head tracking, you don't want to make your eyes veer too off center from the screen, so overall, this device has an excellent turn radius and range, which will work great in homemade cockpits, which can sometimes be quite far from the screen and from the head tracking camera. Overall, you shouldn't have any issues with tracking distance with this device. The build quality on the IR TrackStar has been great for me. It is made from a filament that is durable and looks professional overall. It comes in a variety of different colors, so you should be able to find something that is to your liking in terms of color, perhaps to match your headset. The IR LEDs are solidly in place and don't move around, and the switch installed to turn it on and off is clicky and feels nice to use. The strap included can secure to most headphone types easily without much in the way of wiggling and will keep it in place to prevent unwanted camera movements when you are in the simulator. Build quality is surely a place where you're going to be satisfied with this product. Products that are provided from other companies like Dell Inclip or Natural Point for their TrackIR head tracker are usually wired. Dell Inclip has a wireless option, but more on that later. And provide a lengthy cable to connect to a USB port. The IR TrackStar is different in the sense that it is completely wireless when in use. This means you don't have an annoying cable dangling near you, and you can easily move around without having to worry much about cables in the way. It also allows for a neater setup as it reduces the need of one less cable when you're in the simulator, allowing for more freedom overall. I can highly recommend you go for wireless over wired, as it provides the same features that a wired model would provide but without the annoyances of having a wire. The battery life is also excellent as it will last 8 hours easily, at least from my use case when I tested how long the battery would last, but at that point I couldn't sim anymore, it probably had more charge available before having to be charged again. The IR TrackStar has compatibility with both TrackIR and OpenTrack tracking software. This means that if you have a broken TrackClip Pro and want something more high quality for TrackIR, you can easily use it for that situation. If you want to use your own IR head tracking camera with OpenTrack, then it will work perfectly for that and the dimensions of the product are provided on the store page for the IR TrackStar. The compatibility means that anyone with proper tracking equipment in need of a replacement for the actual IR LEDs can easily use this in their setup with a lot of ease, without much headache. The IR TrackStar is not a perfect device, sadly. One of the first issues I had with it, however it is a minor but still must be mentioned issue, is that the device is almost twice the weight of other wireless tracker alternatives like the Dell Inclip wireless tracker. It comes in at 4.1 ounces compared to the Dell Inclip, which only comes in at 2.1 ounces. This means you will notice it at first on how heavy it is, especially if you're coming from a wired setup where there was no battery at all. The battery is ultimately the reason for the weight, but you are getting a much longer battery life from the weight trade-off and more powerful IR LEDs than other alternatives, allowing you to use this from a longer range than other available trackers on the market. The device can also have some issues with certain kinds of headphones. This is listed in the description of the IR TrackStar's Etsy page and can be checked there. The example used there is the G533, which can be a bit touchy without some modification by applying some tape. My headphones that I use, the Sony WH-1000 XM3s, have no issues with the IR TrackStar and work excellently for my use case without much in the way of issue. Some people have also complained that their headphones slip with the device on their headphones, but this is again a headphone compatibility issue. I recommend you contact the seller of the device, RJ SimTech, to see if your headphones will be a good fit for the device. The device also has some charging issues when using certain types of chargers and outlets. In my case, I was trying to use a Samsung Galaxy charger on a surge protector, but it was not working due to the outlet and was solved by plugging it directly into a wall outlet. I contacted RJ Simtek about this, and it is listed in the description of the Etsy page, but it essentially has to do with the circuit protections to ensure that the lithium-ion battery and circuitry is kept safe by ensuring a proper voltage and amperage control and regulation. This can prove to be an issue for some people with no available wall outlets and only outlets on surge protectors, but you really don't need to charge this device frequently, so you could probably just unplug some certain device, but for the most part, you must have an outlet somewhere in your home. But this is something to keep note of, especially if you don't. My final opinion on the IR TrackStar is that it is a worthy replacement for the TrackClip Pro from TrackIR and any wired options you may be using right now. It provides excellent tracking quality and works for a long time, allowing for a low amount of charge cycles between sessions. If you currently own a wireless head tracking device, I'd say don't replace it for this option if you're happy with what you have right now. While this wireless head tracker is great, I don't think it is good enough to replace your current wireless head tracker. In the end though, if you need a new head tracker, this is probably what I would recommend right now, to be your first choice as it provides the most in features and quality compared to the other options available and allows for a usage in a wide variety of setups. Just try to make sure there is a suitable spot to strap the device around to on your headset. Of course, if you have any questions about the device, please send them to RJ Simtek over at his Etsy page and ask him if it will work with your headset or any other questions you might have about the device, and he'll be glad to help you. He's been very helpful when I was asking him during the conversations we were having, and he's just been an overall great person to talk to. So do make sure that you contact him, and if you have any questions about the device, of course. Hopefully you found this video useful. If you did, please leave a like and comment. If you have any questions, please leave any suggestions for things that you might want to see further on the channel. This has been a VK Northern video, and I hope to see you all in the next one.